I grew up in countryside. My parents are farmers.
Dunwei Wang spent the first half of his life in rural China, but left the countryside behind to study and work. He's lived in Hefei, China as an undergrad, Pasadena as a postdoc, and now Boston as a professor.
I enjoy the lifestyle I have now. We should be able to live with the same living standards, but don't have to do so much damage to the environment.
For Wang, resolving this tension comes down to energy. So he uses his chemistry to make materials that can harness sunlight. Naturally, plants are his inspiration.
Take a look at this leaf. It's incredibly simple, but it's doing unbelievably complex chemistries.
Plants use sunlight to split water, H2O, into hydrogen and oxygen. The resulting energy lets them grow and make seeds and flowers, but they also store some of that energy for later, as sugar. And this is what Wang's mirroring in his lab, both energy production and storage, using the same material. What you're holding in your hand could be the way we collect energy in the future.
Yes, that's correct.
If we zoom in on the material in this petri dish, this is what we'd see: a metal lattice of titanium and silicon bathed in salt water.
This is where the magic happens.
When sunlight shines onto this lattice, it provides enough energy to split water into oxygen, which escapes into the air, and hydrogen gas, which is where the energy is stored. Later, when it's needed, the energy is released by a controlled burning of the hydrogen. Wang's shown it's possible to split water both efficiently and cheaply.
We have just warmed up. We haven't really get to the home run yet, but we're getting there.
Wang says his home run will be to perform better than plants. Before his materials end up on the market, though, he has to perfect and scale up the design. But one day, he envisions them covering our rooftops, collecting and storing the sun's energy, and supplying us with the electricity we need.
We need to provide solutions to our children, and this is one of them.